Bonjour, I'm Joseph Gay Lussac. I was born in December 6, 1778, in Saint Leonard de Noblat, France.
My parents were Antoine Gray and Leonard Borner. We were four gay siblings. I was the eldest. Oh, si, sois, moi. Sadly, the French Revolution affected my family. My father was arrested, and the gay family ended up losing all of our money. We were sad. I was one of the greatest French chemists and physicists of the 19th century. This successful destiny of mine was based on a great lie. My father sent me to a boarding school in Paris to study law. However, I had a great interest in chemistry, so I started to study math and science. Chemistry, not law. It led to me passing a really hard test to enter the new École Polytechnique. After my graduation, I attended to L'École Nationale des Ponts et Chaussées. In 1801, I withdrew from that school and I became a research assistant of Claude-Louis Berthollet, another French chemist and politician. My most acknowledged accomplishment was the Gay Law, the Gay-Lussac Law. P1 over T1 equals P2 over T2. Oh, I also remember meeting with Louis-Jacques Thénard at the École Polytechnique. We decomposed a boric acid by using fused potassium, which led to our discovery of boron. I was one of the 72 names honored with inscriptions on the Eiffel Tower in Paris, the same city of my ultimate death in May 9, 1850.
Jacques Charles.
I was born on November 12, 1746, in Bourges, France. I was the only child. I went and married Julie Francoise Bouchard, that was only 37 years old, younger than moi. I'm not here to talk about my lovely young wife, but I must say, she was beautiful.
I was inducted into the French Academy of Sciences for invention purposes due to my great reputation and contributions in the science field. For those reasons, I was selected to be one of the professors at the Conservatoire des Arts et Métiers, which was one of the most prolific French schools intended for the promotion of science and industry through education and research.
My most notable contribution was my law, the Charles Law, V1 over T1 equals V2 over T2. I am also remembered and honored in history for being the first to develop and travel in the hydrogen balloon, which I worked on with Robert Brothers. Oh, I remember that moment of the three of us in our pursuit of greatness and madness in the developing of the biggest hydrogen balloon ever recorded in our time. I must confess that at the beginning of my career life, I wasn't so sure to go for the sciences. For that reason, I worked in finance. It was there where I realized what my true passion was. I thought to myself, I despise this. I'm going to the sciences.
The sciences.
I died with 77 years old in the beautiful Paris on April 23rd, 1823. I feel so bad that I left my love Julie with 38 years old.
Oi, M. Robert Boyle.
I am Robert Boyle. I am Robert Boyle.
Robert Boyle!
I was born on January 25th, 1616. In Lisbon, County, Republic of Ireland. Hello. Ireland.
Boyle.
I was the 14th child and 7th son of Richard IV
Boyle, the first Earl of Cork. His mother was Catherine, daughter of Geoffrey Fenton, who was then going to be Secretary of State for Ireland, one of the wealthiest families in Ireland.
When I was 8 years old, I started my education in Eton College from 1635 to 1638. Oh, then I travelled to Florence to meet and study with the great Galileo Galilei, who invented the telescope, thermometer, compass, and more. I was amazed with his understanding of math, physics, and the sciences. I adopted his principles and followed his studies. However, he died shortly after. Later, I went to University College, Oxford. My most famous accomplishment was my law, the Boyle's Law, P1V1=P2V2. I also had great inventions such as the vacuum chamber air pump. I was offered the presidency of the Royal Society in 1680 and the episcopacy, but declined both. I was tutored in three different languages, Latin, Greek, and French. I died in December 31st, 1691 in London, United Kingdom.